You know, you may be a player that plays Fortnite games every single day, and you find yourself making the same mistakes that ruin any chances of getting high kill games or even victory royales. Watching a large variety of controller players performing, you know, I found that these mistakes are more common to what they seem. Crucial, yet straightforward mistakes are made almost every game that can be avoided, right? And these mistakes can be the difference in the outcome of a match. I've seen people improve by finding these mistakes one by one and implementing a way to fix them. It's safe to say after a couple days of practice, you can improve so much that you can even compete against pro players at the highest level. These are the small mistakes that can often make you feel like you're just not good enough to come out on top. But don't worry, my friends, I'm here. We've identified five of the most common ones, and we're going to be showing you guys how to fix them with ease. What's going on, guys? This is your guy. That's right, your friend, the one and only Keith Allen. I want to let you know that I am your number one fan. Make sure to connect with me as soon as you can on my Instagram, because I want you to succeed not only in playing this game, but also in life. I really, truly, truly, truly believe in you. I wouldn't be doing this if I didn't. You all have greatness, guys. Greatness on the inside of you. But right before we dive into the video, you guys already know the drill. Visit ProGuys.com for 24/7 on-demand coaching from some of the best of the best. We added all new guide exclusive videos for pro members, as well as all the up-to-date news articles from your favorite pros. So don't miss out. Click that link down below and smash that like button. All right, ladies and gentlemen, sit down, relax, and enjoy this amazing video. Let's do it. At number five, we have one of the most overlooked aspects of Fortnite, in my opinion, and that is reaction time. You said what? What happened? And that's exactly how some of you guys react. Many players play tons of games a day without paying any attention to their reaction time. Are you serious? Being able to quickly throw up walls or spin and aim can be the difference between taking 30 or 100 additional damage. Reaction time. Woo! It is significant, my friends, yet barely worked on. You know, we know many people that have struggled with their reaction time, especially on controller. It's not easy to react to getting shot in the back when you can't flick your wrist and turn around in milliseconds. But thanks to building speed, we can balance that out. Yay. The best method to start is to focus on clicking and reacting to situations really quickly. So, the best way is to start off by doing things at a slower pace, then gradually increase your speed until you become fast at it as if you already mastered building in shots. Just try pulling out your weapons or building in a quicker manner. So the way a lot of people start is that they click the build button as fast as they can when they get shot, which puts you into build mode, which turns more quickly than regular aiming. So while doing this, you can also flick your right analog stick to the side and keep it there until you built around yourself entirely. What you guys want to do is press your switch mode button and jump into build mode while flicking your analog stick. Be quick though, because you have to do this at the exact same time. Focusing on this will improve your reaction time significantly over time. The brain works in a way where its speed can be dramatically enhanced with practice. Without going too deep into anatomy and all that, I don't feel like being that guy right now, but we could just say that the more you do something with intention, guess what's gonna happen? The faster that you're gonna get at it. So focus on your reaction time and stop playing in slow motion, because you're not gonna win that way, period. And throw up those walls a little bit faster. Trust me, it'll make you insanely better, and you'll definitely start seeing a really big difference. All right, coming in at number four. Okay, I got something good for everybody, so you need to like check this out right now, all right? How many times have you gone into a match and you started cranking 90s and building techniques and you're showing off, you're confident, you're feeling good about yourself, and you left your opponents in the dust, but then realized that you had no more mats? You're like, dun, dun, dun. This is awkward, and I'm about to die. Overbuilding is a common mistake, and it's one that is becoming more predominant as time just goes on. This is because creative warriors are changing the standards for building at an insanely fast pace, and creative tends to have a very large audience across multiple platforms. This makes their building techniques popular amongst the Fortnite community. But believe it or not, the majority of tricks shown in creative montages and cool clips are just downright flashy and a waste of materials, okay? Being a good player, you know, you always have to have the tendency to learn the newest and the best building moves, right? But at some point, you have to realize that the majority of these moves can't actually be used in arena and public matches. The material cap simply does not allow you to crank your high ground retakes and maneuvers the same way you can in creative, right? To give you a good perspective on this mistake, let's say that you're in a competitive arena game and you farmed up 1,500 materials ready for the game. Why didn't I just say 1,500? That was weird. Anyways, at any time, you could be met with an opponent that wants to fight you. Now, let's say this opponent is engaging in a 1v1, right? And you're going for high ground to get the advantage. Although there are hundreds of fresh ways that you could just get the high ground, you choose the popular one that may end up getting you the win, but you're left dry of materials. And now you're going to the end game against opponents with max while you're almost out. And then you hear the dun dun dun. You do not want to hear that song. That means that you're about to die. Okay, so how could you have avoided this? It's quite simple, actually, the professor said. All you have to do is use the building techniques that are most useful instead of the ones that are popular. I suggest using ramp floor 90s like Tfue, which will save you up to 60 extra mats as you won't waste them on walls. Another good building move is the reverse 90, which can be used while doing a protected ramp tunnel. All of these are in our past high ground retake videos, so be sure to check those out to see some tremendous high ground retakes that can be done in matches without wasting materials. My guys, my friends, we say it time and time again, why aren't you listening to us? Aiming in Fortnite is perhaps the most crucial aspect of the game. Being able to hit your shots and deal massive amounts of damage is absolutely necessary to be able to dominate opponents and win battles. So, why aren't people constantly working on improving it? Sure, a lot of keyboard and mouse players do things like Kovacs, I understand, but what about controller players? There are many different ways and opportunities that you guys have to improve your aim. You know, we've known people who put in hundreds of hours into simply improving their aim. This is because Fortnite has a core concept that is unknown to many. You cannot be shot, all right, without having the opportunity to shoot back. Plain and simple. In Fortnite, it's impossible to shoot someone without them having an angle to deal damage back, okay? And this is something many people are not aware of. The only situations where it's possible is if the enemy isn't fully aware when you go for the shot. Shooting people when you get the chance is very important if you ever want to be a great player. Incorporating reaction time, timing, aiming, and gunplay are very important for dealing damage. The most important aspect is aim, obviously. Aiming accurately, at critical damage points like the head or the shields on mechs can make a world of difference in close range fights. Getting one or two extra headshots will give you the advantage you need to finish out the fight. We personally use aim training maps such as the ones in our previous pro guides videos and also do some other mental training to prime our aim. One of the things is focusing very specifically on your aiming for your first few games online. Whether it's creative or you just jump into a lobby, you always gotta focus on your aim to improve it and get it warmed up. Aiming is a skill, ladies and gentlemen, that is very based on muscle memory and coordination. But what's interesting about the aiming mechanics in Fortnite is that they can actually be improved instantly through merely focusing. So make sure to incorporate at least 10 minutes of aim training every single day. By observing and lining up shots, you can instantly become more accurate. The reason many controller players like you tend to have issues with aiming is because they're so busy focusing on the other aspects of the game. Fortnite is a game that has a ton of different ways to play, okay? You could be building, editing, using consumables, throwing grenades, driving vehicles, doing backflips with the gun. Sorry, no backflips, but wouldn't that be dope though? Man. But what's most important is aiming. So instead of focusing on doing all these other things, put the majority of your focus on your aim. One last tip is to build less and aim more during your first games on, and these will force you to focus on it so that you can survive, okay? You won't improve your aim by overbuilding all the time, will you? Yes, I'm waiting on you to respond. Yes, yes, you with the shoes on. Yes, you, yeah, not your head, thank you. At number two, we have the common misconception that controller players can't build as fast as PC players. Have you heard that? Maybe you've said that. I see so many controller players genuinely believe that they cannot outbuild other players simply because they have more frames or play on a keyboard and mouse. I used to think this too, and not a day goes by that I laugh at myself for letting this hold me back from getting better. The truth is that controller players can build just as fast as any keyboard and mouse player can. This is because the building in Fortnite is all about skill and muscle memory. It's barely about speed and rotation, guys. Look at slow sensitivity controller players, for example. Many controller players can outbuild 10 to 10 sensitivity players even if they play on slow sensitivities like 5 to 5. This is because they know how to position their perspective better to be able to build just as efficiently as those players. Playing on fast sensitivities is like a crutch. You're giving yourself the option to flick around your aim and do unnecessary movements to build just as fast as anyone else. Sure, it may look faster and cooler, but at the end of the day, you're not really doing yourself any good by being all over the place. Who are you, the Tasmanian devil? Yep, remember him? He was actually one of my favorites. But don't play like that. But he can still be your favorite though. And that's the fundamental concept that drives this point. You can build as efficiently and quickly as PC players because it all comes down to muscle memory and skill. Even if you're playing on a 60 FPS on a console, you'll still be able to do the exact same building tricks as PC players on 240Hz. Because it's all about muscle memory, guys. It truly comes down to how much you practice and perfect your building moves. So if you shut yourself down at the start and you say, I can't compete because I don't have higher frames, man, that's nonsense. And don't ever use the word I can't. Just take that out of your vocabulary right now. Do not say those two words together. To improve this aspect of your game, jump into a creative lobby and just start practicing and start building slowly. And you're going to start getting better and better than those players. And most importantly, please do not go into a fight without confidence. Having confidence is the key. Having confidence is like us having oxygen. You need it to live. Unless you're an alien, which means you don't need oxygen. Hey, you never know. Our videos go out all across the galaxy. Last but certainly not least, we have the famous sensitivity. How many of you guys have watched a video that was tilted best sensitivity for controller players? I know I have, and I honestly can't blame you. It's natural to wonder what sensitivities the best players in the world are playing. So to be 150,000% honest with you, it's not exactly a bad thing. Basing your sensitivity off of another player doesn't mean that you're using the wrong sensitivity. What's important though is that you mold and shape a sensitivity into the perfect sensitivity for you. Let's say, for example, that you decide to play 7-7 because Ghost Aiden uses this sensitivity, but you find that it's too fast for you because you're missing a lot of your shots, and your builds are overplacing. Although it takes time to get used to sensitivity, you could find that even with practice, this sensitivity still is not making you a better player. This is a sign that you need to change it up, guys. Using Ghost Aiden as a starting point is fine to do so, right? But you must be able to fine-tune that sensitivity to your own needs. Everyone's brain works at different speeds, and everyone's coordination works in different ways. You must be able to find a sensitivity that just works best for you. And the best way to do so is by hopping into some games and just testing it out until you find the perfect sensitivity that matches your style. We recommend that you watch our video on the best sensitivity and use that as a starting point. You know, it's a great sensitivity that works well for the majority of controller players, but don't be afraid to tweak it to your own liking. Sensitivities are a sensitive topic. I keep saying the word sensitivity. I love it because I'm sensitive as well. No, I'm playing. Well, I am. Whatever. So be willing to be flexible with it and try new things until you find yourself performing better. We want to see you guys succeeding, and a good, reliable sensitivity is crucial to do so. We hope this video showed you the mistakes that you're most likely making. Hopefully, our tips will help you guys fix those with ease. Controller players will always, always have their place as some of the best players in the world, and we would like to keep it that way. Once again, this is your guy, your friend, the one and only Keith Allen. I want to let you know that I'm your biggest fan, and I truly believe in you. You have greatness on the inside, so let it out. Let it shine, man. Let it shine. Have a good time playing this amazing game. And as always, hey, we hope you enjoyed this video. Hit that like button if you enjoyed, and throw all your thoughts and comments down below. We appreciate all the support, and we'll see you on the next one.